Good morning, children. In our previous period, we have completed the explanation of poem Once I Saw a Little Bird. In this poem, our small boy shared his experience when he saw a bird and what happened when he called that bird and when he asked that bird to stop. Okay, next. In this, we have completed our first exercise comprehension also. Okay. Our next question answer, I am going to explain you. B. Answer the questions. See, in this, first question is, what did the poet see once? So, the poet saw a bird once. Okay, once I saw a little bird. So, poet saw a little bird once. Where was the poet going to say? He was going to the window. See, from here, he was asking that bird, how do you do? That means he was going to the window to say, how do you do? Did the bird wait for the poet? No, the bird did not wait for the poet. When the bird asked him, how do you do? Then bird did not reply, bird did not stop there, but he flew away. Okay? So you can turn your page number 34. See, children, on page number 34, you can see life skills and values. In this, it is often difficult for birds to find water in summer. How can we help them? Children, it is a big problem for anyone, for human being also, to find water in summer season. And this is a story of birds. We human beings can talk and we can get water from anywhere. We can do anything to get water. But these birds are helpless. They don't get water in summer season. So children, you can put the pot filled with water in your balcony. In any roadside also, you can put that at the door side, at the gate side of your house also, in the entry of your house. And other places from where the birds can drink the water easily, you can put pots filled with water. This is the best option. Next, imagine a bird's legs get stuck in the net or thread laying on the roof of your house. What would you do? So children, what we can do if any bird's leg stuck in thread or in net laying in our on the roof of our house? It is very big problem for birds when birds' leg stuck in a net or thread laying on our roof. So we people are responsible for that. We people should be aware of this, that it causes problem. The animals, the birds have to face problems because of this. And that's why we cut all the nets and threads and we throw it in dustbin properly. Whenever we work with threads or net on roof or anywhere else, we should collect all these after finishing our work. And when that bird get hurt or stuck its leg, we can cut that net and make him free to fly. The same situation occur at the time of Uttarayan. At the time of Uttarayan, what happened? Many people, they were flying kites, and they, what happened? So many threads were there laying on the roofs or laying on the terrace. And what happened? It causes injury to the birds or any animals also passing through that threads. So we people should collect after that occasion, we should collect all the threads and we should throw it in dustbin. Okay, so children, you can do this for the betterment, for the sake of these birds and some animals also. Okay, so you should keep it in your mind. Next, vocabulary. In the poem, the bird hops. It moves by jumping with both feet together. Children, the meaning of hopping means to move by jumping with both feet together. In this way, we can jump by with the help of two feet together. Okay, so we have some meanings and we have to match that. See, here are some more words that tell us about moments. Match them with their meanings. So here I am reading the meaning words that climb, roll, skip and swim. So climb means to go to the top of anywhere. Okay, then roll means rolling. This, that means to move, turn over and turn over. Okay, and then skip. So I am going to read all these meanings also. To move forward lightly and quickly, making a little jump with each step. This is the meaning of skip. Okay, in skip means जो दोरी खेलते हैं ना रस्सी, उससे हम लोग one by one step कूदते हैं, jumping करते हैं. Okay, फटाफट से, that is skipping. Then this is to move through water in horizontal position using the arms and legs. जहाँ हम पानी में जैसे सो जाते हैं ऐसे हाथ और पैर से हिलते हैं सो के, that is swimming. So here I match it with sea. The next, to turn over and move in a particular direction, that is rolling. Okay, that's rolling. Two, next, to go up something towards the top, that is climbing. Okay, to go up something towards the top, that means upar chadna, that is called climbing. Okay, so in this way you should match these action words with the meanings. Next activity is, let's play a word game. There are some action words given to you and you should, because you are not in school nowadays, you can play this game with your parents or with your grandparents. See, here some action words are given to you. Bend. Bend means jhukna. Yahan par jo word diye hai, one team should act according to that action words and other team may recognize that action. Okay, jaise dabsharaz mein khelte hai, ek team aati hai action karke jati hai and second team have to identify, second team have to recognize that action. Okay, in the same way, bend means jhukna. झुकना ऐसे, दिस इज बेंड. ओके, देन क्लैप, क्लैपिंग करना. क्लाइंब, ऊपर चढ़ना. देन क्रॉल, क्रॉल मीन्स छोटे बच्चे चलते हैं ना, इन दिस वे यू हैव टू वॉक लाइक अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड. देन डांस, डांस करना. डाइव, डाइव मीन्स पानी में कूदना, जो पानी में कूदते हैं ना, दैट इज कॉल्ड डाइविंग. हॉप, हॉप मीन्स जस्ट आई एक्सप्लेन यू. देन जॉग, जॉगिंग करना, जो मम्मी पापा या ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स भी जाते हैं ना जॉगिंग करने अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग, दैट इज कॉल्ड जॉगिंग. देन मार्च, मार्च पास्ट, इन दिस वे मार्च पास्ट, जो पीटी में है आपको सिखाते हैं या जो एनसीसी कैंप में जो बॉयज गर्ल्स करते हैं, दैट इज मार्च पास्ट. देन पुल, खींचना, पुश, धक्का देना. रोल, रन, शेक, स्किप, skipping, dori kudna. Then stamp, stamp means paddle ki awaaj karna aise. Then sway, a swim, swim means tairna. Tiptoe, tiptoe means aise khade hona toes ke upar. Okay, that is tiptoe. Then turn, turn means aise turn hona, ghumna. Twist, mudna. Then walk, chalna. Wave and wiggle. Okay, in this way ये सारे जो वर्ड्स है इसका आप एक्शन करो तो आपके पेरेंट्स रिकॉग्नाइज करेंगे ओके okay? या फिर आपके पेरेंट्स एक्ट करते हैं आप रिकॉग्नाइज करो. इन दिस वे यू कैन प्ले दिस गेम विद योर पेरेंट्स और ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स ओके चिल्ड्रन. वंस आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द वर्ड्स एंड मीनिंग्स ऑफ दिस पोएम. सी वर्ड्स मीनिंग्स हॉप टू जम्प एंड मूव फॉरवर्ड. जम्प एंड मूव फॉरवर्ड ओके. देन टेल the long part at the back of the body of an animal or bird. Tail means जो पीठ के ऊपर एक पार्ट होता है एनिमल्स के या बर्ड के दैट इज कॉल्ड टेल ओके. एंड ओनली एनिमल्स एंड बर्ड्स हैव टेल. ह्यूमन बींग्स डोंट हैव टेल. अंडरस्टूड ओके चिल्ड्रन. सी यू हियर. वी हैव कंप्लीटेड दिस पोएम. बाय.